The lesson number 15, block called class 5 EVS. So in this chapter we'll read a story, and with the help of that story we'll try to understand that when we are blowing the air from our mouth, so how it becomes hot or how it becomes cold according to the situation. So what is the reason behind it? And the story which has been taken into this chapter is, it is being written by our former president of India, Dr. Zakir Hussain. So he has written many stories about children. So it is a small story taken from the book which he has written. So let's start. So it is a story about a woodcutter. So there was a woodcutter. Every day in the morning he used to go to the forest to cut wood. In the evening he would sell the wood in the city. So one day he went deep into the forest. It was cold winter. His fingers were becoming numb. So his fingers were becoming numb means there is so much of cold that the fingers were starting to stop working. That it is so much of cold that he is unable to use the axe to cut down the wood. Every now and then the woodcutter would put down his axe and bring his hand close to his mouth. Then he would blow hard on them to warm them. So you can see in the picture how the woodcutter is blowing the air on the hand so that he can get the little warm air on the hands, and he can make his fingers stop becoming numb. So while he was cutting down, Mia Baliste was watching him from a corner. So is he Mia Baliste? So in many stories, Dr. Zakir Hussain has used an imaginary character who comes in the stories. So in this story also, that imaginary character is there. The name of that character is Mia Baliste. So you can see here in the story. So Mia Baliste is watching all this when this thing was happening, that woodcutter is blowing air on the fingers. He do not understand what is happening. So he began to wonder what all that was about, but he could not understand it. He got up thinking that he could go and ask the woodcutter. After walking a little, he came back thinking that woodcutter may not like being asked. So finally Mia Baliste could not help himself. He went hopping to the woodcutter and said, "Hello brother, if you don't mind, can I ask you something?" So the Mia Baliste was curious that why the woodcutter is doing so, why he is blowing the air on the hand. So he was confused. So seeing this tiny person, woodcutter was amazed and amused. He was very surprised. So from where this kind of a small human being has come here? Who is he? Why is he here like this? But he hid his smile and said, of course, ask what you want. So Mia Baliste asked, "All I want to ask is, why do you blow from your mouth onto your hands?" said Mia Baliste. So he want to ask that what is the reason behind this. So let's see what happened next. So the woodcutter replied, "It is too cold and my hands are frozen. So I blow on them to warm them up a little. Then when they get cold again, I warm them again by blowing." So by blowing means the woodcutter is blowing the air on the hand. So Mia Baliste nodded like they are. He started to move his head in up and down movement like he has understood. So that's it. Okay, like this. And with that he moved off, but he stays nearby and kept a close watch on him. So Mia Baliste moved away and again he was watching that what woodcutter is doing. So let's see what happened next in the story. We'll see the pictures afterwards. Soon it was afternoon. The woodcutter began to think of lunch. So he picked up two stones and made a chula. So what is a chula? Chula is a kind of a temporary stove where you can, in this picture you can see how with the help of two stones he has made a chula, and in between he has put firewood so that he can create a fire to cook the food. So let's see what he wants to cook for the lunch. So he picked up two stones and made a chula. He lit a fire and put a small handi. So small handi is a earthen pot made up of clay, filled with potatoes to boil. The wood was damp. Wood was damp mean the wood which he was using to boil the potatoes, it was little wet. So द वुड कटर बेंड डाउन एंड ब्लू ऑन फायर टू हेल्प इट बर्न. सो बरिस्ते वॉज वॉचिंग हिम फ्रॉम अ डिस्टेंस. अरे, सो ही वॉज वेरी सरप्राइज, दैट्स अ एक्सप्रेशन, अरे. ही सेट टू हिमसेल्फ, देयर ही गोज अगेन ब्लोइंग फ्रॉम हिज माउथ, डज फायर कम आउट ऑफ हिज माउथ. सो अगेन मिया बलिस्टे इज सरप्राइज दैट वट ही इज डूइंग, दैट हाउ द इज इट फायर इज कमिंग फ्रॉम द माउथ. सो वुड कटर वॉज फीलिंग वेरी हंग्री, ही टुक आउट अ पटेटो फ्रॉम हांडी एंड ही ट्राइड टू ईट इट, बट पटेटो वॉज टू हॉट. ही अगेन बिगेन टू ब्लो इट लाइक दिस, देन अगेन, अरे, अगेन मिया बलिस्टे सेट टू हिमसेल्फ, ही इज ब्लोइंग अगेन एंड नाउ वट इज ही गोइंग टू बर्न पटेटो. आफ्टर ब्लोइंग अ फ्यू मोर फू 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 लाइक दिस, द वुड कटर पुट इट इन हिज माउथ एंड बिगेन टू ईट इट. सो हेयर इन द स्टोरी वी कैन अंडरस्टैंड दैट वुड कटर इज फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वैन ब्लोइंग ऑन टू द फायर ही इज हेल्पिंग द फायर टू बर्न, ओके, एंड आफ्टर वर्ड्स वैन ही टेक आउट अ पटेटो फ्रॉम द हांडी, सो द पटेटो वॉज वेरी हॉट, सो the air which is coming from the mouth of the woodcutter, it is colder in compared to the hot potatoes. So woodcutter is trying to cool down the potatoes by blowing onto them, but Mia Baliste is not understanding this thing. So let's see what happened next. So now Mia was very surprised, he could not stop himself. Off he went hopping to the woodcutter. Hello brother, if you don't mind, can I ask you a question again? So woodcutter replied, not at all, ask whatever you want. So Mia Baliste said, this morning you told me that you blew on your hands to warm them up, now you are blowing on this potato which is already so hot, why do you want to make it hotter? So he was thinking, when he was blowing the air on the hands, it means he is making them hot or warm, but when he is blowing the air on the potato, so he is asking that why you want to make potato a more hotter. So then the woodcutter reply, no my little friend, the potato is too hot, I am blowing on it to cool it down. When he heard this, Mia Baliste's face become white, he began to tremble with fear and started to back away. So Mia Baliste was very surprised and very afraid. He thought woodcutter is a kind of a person that who have some powers, so he got afraid. So woodcutter was a good man, he said, what's wrong Mia, are you trembling because of the cold? So but Mia Baliste was getting afraid of woodcutter, because woodcutter is blowing hot air, woodcutter is blowing cold air, he was thinking he is not safe there. So when he was safe distance away, he said to himself, what kind of a creature is this? Surely he must be a ghost or a jinn. Blow hot, blow cold with the same breath, it is just not possible. That's right, there are some things which cannot be, but they are. So with this story we understand the air which comes out from our mouth, it can be hot or cold compared to the situation. Suppose when it was very cold and woodcutter wants to give little warm to the hands, he blow on the hands, so the air which coming which start to come out of the mouth of the woodcutter, it was hot in compared to the outside environment, so it makes the hand little warm. But in case of when he wants to cool down the hot potatoes, the air which is coming out of the mouth, it was cooler in compared to the hot potatoes or to the surrounding environment. So this is how is the difference. So now let's move to the further, let's see before that. So inhaled air, the air we breathe in is called inhaled air, and the air we breathe out is called exhaled air. So when we breathe in, we breathe oxygen, and when we breathe out, that is carbon dioxide. A normal breathing rate is 12 to 15 times per minute. So you can check by doing a little activity. Put a finger in front of your nose and look at the watch. In 1 minute, how many breathing in out you are doing. So you can calculate. This is how the normal breathing rate is. So our breath is humid. It contains water vapor. If you do not know, you stand in a front of mirror and you try to blow air on the mirror. You will see the mirror will get little blurry. and you will see small small water droplets on it. So that's why we can tell it contains water vapors. We blow air from our mouth to warm our cold hand, and we blow into some musical instrument to produce sound also, as you can see in the picture. And we blow to cool hot things, such as suppose I provide you a hot milk, hot coffee, hot tea or hot water. What will you do? You will start blowing on it to make it little cooler so that you can drink nicely. And we blow air to lit fire also, you know, for burning for fire oxygen is very necessary, air is very necessary. If there is no air, fire cannot be there. Okay, so for burning anything or for fire, air is also needed. And always remember, hot air is light and rises up. Okay, so hot air will go in which direction? Toward the sky. And the cold air is heavy and comes down, so the cold air will come toward the ground. Breathing exercises, this is how you can do your little yoga exercises for breathing, some yoga postures which can help you after doing a good quality of breathing, and your lungs can become strong. So give reasons why do we blow on hot potatoes to make them little cooler. So there are a few activities, so let's see what we can do. So here, coming to the next one, so can you think of any other way in which you can use warmth from your breath? So you can see here, it is a little boy and he is hurt, and his sister is doing what? He has rolled a towel and he is blowing the air on the hot on the towel. So when that area of the towel becomes little warm, then she is using that warm to heal the pain of the brother. So what how this warmth of the breath will help? So the warmth of the breath will help in reducing the swelling. Okay, so it will give a little relief to the brother. So Baliste saw that woodcutter was trying to cool a hot potato by blowing on them. What could happen if he had eaten potatoes without cooling them? If he has not cooled down the potato, then the mouth of woodcutter would become damaged, or it can become burned from the inside. Tongue can burn, okay, like this. So have you ever burnt your tongue when you ate or drank something which is too hot? Sometimes it happens when we are feeling hungry, we eat or drink very hot food, so sometimes we burn our tongue and it takes 1 or 2 days to get the relief. So these things happen. So that's why when before eating or taking anything hot, we should blow on them. So this is how we can do. In the picture one, you can see Minnie is trying to cool her tea by blowing on it. So which do you think will be hotter, Minnie's tea or the air she blew on from her mouth? So obviously the air which is coming from the tea, it will be hotter. That's why Minnie is using the air which is coming from her mouth to cool down. So if we'll compare the air which is you can see hot air is rising from the tea, it means tea is much more hotter. So in picture 2 you can see Sonu is feeling very cold. He kept blowing on his hand. So now think and write which will be cooler, Sonu's hand or his breath. So here we can see obviously outside temperature is much colder if we compare to the air which is coming from the mouth. That's why he is using the air by blowing onto hand so that it can become little warm. For the next one also, what other things do you know? Do you blow air from your mouth? As you can see, kind of a windmill the player kid is playing with, and he's blowing air so that the windmill can rotate. And you can also make a paper whistle like this and make a small clip video, and you can send to me on WhatsApp also. And you can use a wrapper of toffee, a leaf, balloon, a cap of pan and any other thing to make a softer whistle. Or you can use all this item and you can make a small video of 10 to 20 seconds or 30 seconds and you can send to me. And many people use different musical instruments like flute, dholak and bean and guitar and mridang. So can you recognize their sound with your eyes closed? Yes. And some instruments like flute and bean, they produce sound when we blow into them. So the air passes through various chambers and it creates sound. So like this only these musical instruments work. So, into the next one. Have you have seen someone blowing onto their spectacles to wipe them? So I have seen many people, they used to do. Why? Because obviously our breath consists of water vapor. So when we blow onto the specs or spectacles on the glasses, the water vapors get there is water vapor present on this mirror, then we can clean the spectacles nicely. So this activity you can also do. Stand in the front of mirror and you try to blow on the mirror. You will see it will become hazy or blurry. It means the water vapor has been present onto the mirror and it has come from your mouth. So this is how you can do. In the next activity also you can do. You can measure your chest size. Suppose whenever you are buying clothes, the main reason of buying clothes, you can see your chest size by taking a inchi tape. So first of all, take a deep breath in and then you measure, and with the help of that size only then you buy the clothes. Okay, you take a deep breath and you hold, then you measure your chest size, then it will be more, and when you become normal you will see there will be the difference in your chest size. So how many breaths in 1 minute? I have already told you 12 to 15 minutes, or sorry, 12 to 15 times per minute. So you can do this activity. Like this boy is putting a finger in the front of nose and he can see that in 1 minute how many times he can breathe. And you can also check, jump 30 times and then you see that you do you feel breathless, that you are breathing in, breathing out very fast. So at that time also try to count in 1 minute how many times you are breathing in and out. Next one. So there is a clock inside you. All you have heard is a tick ticky tick of a clock. So inside of our body we are talking about is heart. So heart is a organ inside our body that works as works of pumping the blood into our body. So this kind of a stethoscope, you can see this girl is make a small example of a stethoscope. So she's trying to hear with the help of a long rubber tube, so that one side of rubber tube is on the ear and another on the cup, and she has placed on the chest so that she can hear the dug dug sound of the heart beat. Like the clock produces the sound of tick tick tick, similarly in the heart, when heart is beating, it means the heart is working of pumping the blood into different parts of the body. So that's why we can say that we have a clock inside our body that produces a sound like tuk 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 tuk, like this. Now another activity, snake tells the flow of air. So I have already told you that whole hot air will go into the upward direction and the cold air will come in the bottom direction. So the cold air will come toward the ground and the hot air will go toward the sky. So with this activity you can see, you take a square paper, you can draw and cut the snake in this way, and you can tie the center of the snake from a thread and place it over a candle. So when the candle will start to burn, the hot air will go in which direction? In up direction. So try to see in which direction the snake starts to move. So in this lesson we learn that the air which is coming from our mouth, it can be hot, it can be cold in compare to the our surrounding or what we are using. Suppose while playing Amit hit a wall, his forehead was swollen. So Didi immediately folded a scarf 4 times, 5 times and blew on it and kept it on Amit's forehead. So he is doing this, she is doing this for giving a relief to the Amit, so that the Amit's forehead which is swollen, it can get little relief. So that's all. With this we have come to an end of chapter that blow hot, blow cold. And children, I will be sharing the link of the another video in which you can see sir from the Mysore is doing various kind of activities and experiment with smaller kids related to this chapter only. So I would like to request you see the both video, this video and that video also. And with this we'll complete the whole chapter. Thank you, have a nice day.